Strontium is one of those elements like uranium or iridium where it seems like every time you see it, it's always associated with something cool like armor-piercing ammunition or antimatter or problematic radioactive waste. Despite its bad boy image and starring role in the Chernobyl disaster, strontium has struggled to maintain any degree of mainstream relevance since the decline of cathode ray tubes, which was previously its biggest market share. Most people don't even think about strontium until they're wondering how to dump even more money into their already over-budget reef aquarium, at which point they are reminded that strontium and molybdenum exist. That said, one industry where strontium is still thriving is pyrotechnics, in which it is the ion of choice for red flames. So why strontium? Well, the only viable candidates for red flame production are strontium, rubidium, and lithium.
Rubidium is a little bit radioactive.
And lithium produces a pinkish flame, so strontium wins by default, which is the best possible way to win. It works quite well, though, and the red color produced by strontium is vibrant, especially when combined with a source of chlorine. The two primary salts of strontium that find their way into fireworks are strontium nitrate and strontium carbonate. I don't have any hard data, but it feels like formulas calling for the nitrate salt dramatically outnumber formulas calling for the carbonate. One reason for this is that strontium nitrate can act as both the oxidizer and the coloring agent, whereas strontium carbonate always needs an external oxidizer. Carbonates in general can also keep flame temperatures lower, and in my opinion the best red is produced at higher temperatures with metallic fuels like aluminum or magnesium, sometimes an alloy of the two. Charcoal and other non-metallic fuels like shellac can be used with strontium nitrate, but often the lower flame temperature will make the red appear a little washed out or pink. You need a good amount of chlorine in the flame to produce a strong red, and you can get some from oxidizers like potassium chlorate or ammonium perchlorate, but the formulas that I consider to be top tier all use a designated chlorine donor like Parlon or PVC. Like most other coloring agents, strontium can be combined with other metal salts to give a variety of colors that are derived from red, such as purple or orange. One of my favorite examples is the so-called Melilac star, which gets its electric purple color from a combination of strontium nitrate and cupric oxide. Big thanks to NT8 on the APC forums for posting this formula, and to Pyrobull on YouTube for posting the video. They may or may not be the same guy. Now, one caveat to using strontium nitrate is that it's pretty hygroscopic, and this means that using water to bind stars made with it often results in stars that take forever to dry, or never actually completely dry at all. Unless you store your strontium nitrate with strong desiccants, it's usually advisable to oven dry it before use, otherwise it won't burn as well and the mass for your formulas will be slightly off due to the massive water contained in the salt. I dry mine in a glass dish in the oven at around 200°C for an hour. Just make sure your significant other is kept in the dark about what's going on. Another reason to use a designated chlorine donor like PVC or Parlon is that you can bind the composition with acetone to make rubber stars without using any water. Be sure to dry your acetone briefly over anhydrous magnesium sulfate or some other compatible drying agent first, because acetone readily absorbs water from the air. Don't store the acetone over anything long term because it'll slowly react. Just dry it once, filter it well, and keep the lid on tight. The same anhydrous binding method can be employed using alcohol with red gum or shellac as a binder, but the same thing applies there. You definitely want to ensure your solvent is dry before using it with strontium nitrate. To save money on chemicals, one thing you can do is just only buy strontium nitrate and then make strontium carbonate on demand for certain formulas. It's super cheap and easy to convert the nitrate to carbonate, but you need nitric acid to do the inverse, and I'm not wasting my nitric acid on something as useless as strontium. You can either use sodium or potassium carbonate to convert your strontium nitrate, and I prefer sodium carbonate because it's so cheap and available. A box of washing soda from your local grocery store will last a lifetime and costs about $4. Or you can order potassium carbonate online for a little more and wait for shipping. The procedure is that you just want to dissolve some strontium nitrate in distilled water and then do the same with your soluble carbonate of choice. I'm just using arbitrary amounts here as proof of concept, but exact stoichiometry is on the screen, which you can obviously scale down. If you do use washing soda, it'll be a little turbid from the impurities, but this is fine for this use. Once you got them dissolved, just pour the solutions together. The strontium carbonate is insoluble in water and it'll come crashing out of solution, so just give it a stir, wait for it to settle, and then filter it off. If you've recently broken your good vacuum filter, then you can just use a coffee filter jammed in your nastiest ceramic Buchner funnel. If you did use sodium carbonate, then you're going to want to wash it to get out as much of the sodium as you can, so just pour a little extra distilled water through your filter and then let it dry. Once it's dry, you should have a crumbly mess of strontium carbonate, but it still has some sodium contamination, so I like to wash it again. I like to boil it on the stirring hot plate for a few minutes, but you can get away with a good manual stirring as well. Either way, once you've got it all into a fine dust again, just wait for it to settle and then filter it same as before. I do this washed up twice, but you can repeat ad nauseum. It's important to wash the sodium out or else your formulas will look a little orange since sodium emits in the yellow spectrum, but if you use potassium carbonate, then you don't need to wash it as much. Now, is this procedure a bit of a pain? Yes, absolutely. Will you ever get all the sodium out? Absolutely not. But if you're super excited to try a certain formula and you don't want to invest in a whole pound of strontium carbonate, then it works. So now on to my favorite topic in chemistry, safety. The big question is, are strontium salts toxic? And the answer is, a little bit, but not really. You should wear gloves as usual, don't eat it, and certainly don't breathe it, but it's nowhere near as hazardous as barium or hexavalent chromium or any of the other veritable poisons that we use in fireworks. The main concern is that your body is just as stupid as your brain and can't tell the difference between calcium and strontium, so it'll put strontium in your bones if you ingest it. This is actually a desired effect in some cases, and many osteoporosis medications are strontium-based, but it's not good if you're otherwise healthy. That said, the average person consumes a few milligrams of strontium daily in the form of sea salt or as a trace mineral in vegetables, so again, it's not exactly cyanide. As long as you're not a weanling male sprig-dawling rat eating 565 milligrams per kilogram of strontium per day, you should be okay. So that about does it for strontium. Let me know if you'd like to see other videos like this on elements and fireworks. Thanks for tuning in. Good luck. Stay green.